We'll update you on this as soon as we can. Here is Michael Hayes, a former Freebird, and the Hardy Boys. I'll pick on the Brood here momentarily, but King, last night on Heat, quite a unique situation occurred.
Yeah, you're not kidding. The Brood, I guess, was fixing to do one of those infamous bloodbaths on Michael Hayes, but you saw somebody, some help showed up for Michael Hayes there at the last minute when the lights came on. The tables were turned on the Brood. They were the victims of their own bloodbath.
So we will see now.
I don't think the Brood liked it.
Six-man tag team action. And it's been a long time since we've seen Michael Hayes inside the ring as a competitor. I'll tell you what, this Rock thing is already tonight. Vince McMahon has been assaulted by...
What are his conditions?
I don't know. I can't get word back. Apparently, he's still being attended to. Vince McMahon has been hospitalized. The Rock, you just heard, is going to be called an ambulance for The Rock. And that leaves one man left on Shane McMahon's hit list, and that's the Rattlesnake, Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And you heard Shane promise the Rattlesnake the hospital bed right alongside Vince's, and now right alongside The Rock. Oh, yeah. Here we go.
Six-man tag team action now. Michael Hayes been called a lot of names, including Doc Hendricks in his time. And the Hardy Boys against the Brood here. And this, I don't know what has really lit the fire. I know the bloodbath of Michael Hayes a few weeks ago. But there's something else is going on here, King, as far as these guys are concerned.
Well, that's true. And we both talked about the Hardy Boys. These are a couple of really talented young athletes. These guys, they may not be as big as a lot of the other WWF superstars, but they have tremendous amount of ability, and they've just lacked a little bit of leadership or guidance, and I think that Michael Hayes thinks he can provide that guidance.
But you've always told me that size didn't matter.
Huh?
And Gangrel now in there. Well, Gangrel, I'll tell you what, the Brood, amazing trio.
Doesn't matter to me.
Jeff Hardy in there now. His brother Matt. And the black shirt there. Of course, I see even a difference in the Hardy Boys' attire. Maybe that's more of the Michael Hayes influence. And there's a teeth shot.
Michael Hayes will knock your teeth out if you're not careful. Gangrel, you better remember that with those fans.
Matt Hardy, hard right hand. These Hardy Boys certainly have a great deal of potential, a lot of upside for them. And the block of the hip toss.
Another block. Oh!
And Gangrel got look out here. Look at the suplex. Nice move. Folks, as soon as we get any kind of word at all on The Rock's condition, we promise you we'll bring it to you.
How bad do you think he looked, JR? Did you see the look on the face of Tony Garea and Sergeant Slaughter there? I mean, it was like, ugh.
Several of those, and they've been around a lot of things in their long careers.
Have you ever seen anything like that? I haven't. No. I've never seen anybody put in a casket and then casket.
There's a roll up. There's a cover and a near fall.
The casket then literally destroyed with The Rock inside by a sledgehammer.
What? Now, and I've never seen that side of Triple H. I mean, you know, Helmsley's he's always been a smooth operator. He's a great technical competitor. There's no doubt. Maybe technically, he may be the soundest technical guy in the WWF.
Yeah, but I'm going to tell you something. That's the new vicious side of Triple H. And I think we're going to see it again tonight when he faces.
Could be over.
When Triple H faces Stone Cold, I think we're going to see that vicious side again.
Just, you know, The Rock he's a lot of things to a lot of people. And I apologize, folks. There should be more to this match. Just six guys are working their tails off here. But
with their hair off.
I've seen that before.
Yeah.
But what we just saw, the sledgehammer in this casket, is totally uncalled for. And it just shows you the links that the corporate minister will go to get what they want.
We got to give credit to Shane McMahon for that.
And there's one man left on the hit list. Nice double team here.
Look at this. Double suplex.
Double vertical suplex, nicely done. There's one man left on that hit list.
Watch this. Whoa! Oh my God!
That's a beautiful high-risk move there. And the Hardys and Hayes. Cheap shot there.
Do you see the confidence that Michael Hayes has instilled in the Hardy Boys? I know I saw him in the back. He's telling, refuse to lose, refuse to lose. I mean, he's just telling these guys, whatever you do, don't lose. Stay in there long enough. Something good's going to happen.
Referee at times in this match has been on the verge of losing complete control.
Hayes.
Michael Hayes very aggressive, but no aggression can compare to Triple H tonight, wielding a sledgehammer. And growing up in Greenwich, I don't know that he ever had his hands on a sledgehammer before in his life. Look at that great move. What a beautiful move there. Springboard by Jeff Hardy.
You know, don't be surprised if you see a little more of that aggression a little bit later on when Triple H takes on The Rock, or when he takes on Stone Cold Steve Austin. I believe Triple H has got just a little more of that aggression left in him for tonight.
Well, Triple H can get famous tonight if he beats the Rattlesnake here, and it could happen.
Could happen. I'm saying it will happen.
Christian of the Brood dealing the blunt of that, and Michael Hayes now wants another tag.
You see the difference. I'll tell you what I see different in the Hardy Boys here tonight. It's aggression. That's what Michael Hayes has instilled in them. In the past, we've seen the Hardy Boys. Oh, they have all these great maneuvers and everything, but they lack the aggression, and they're showing it tonight.
6 men in this matchup. Eight men, big men. This Sunday on the pay-per-view extravaganza. It'll be the union meeting the corporate ministry. The big show, Mankind. Ken Shamrock can test versus a corporate ministry led by the big boss man, Viscera, and the Acolytes. Nice counter here.
Oh, man. Those guys are still fighting in the back, the union and those guys?
Well, we need the militia back there. And now another high-risk move coming up here.
Oh, man!
And Christian Mitt, Matt Hardy, coming off the second rope there.
Well, I'll tell you, the union and the ministry confrontation is going to continue no matter what, because a little bit later on, we got the big show.
Gosh! Look at Edge. Edge just exploded on Jeff Hardy.
Now, look at that. Oh, man!
High risk, high impact move there.
Oh.
And Michael Hayes got the cheap shot in. And
pretty proud of himself. Oh, look out, Michael!
Oh, this is going to be
ugly. Face. Oh, man!
Edge is just dominated the Hardys and Michael Hayes in this exchange.
Poor Michael!
And now the Brood has taken right back over in this six-man tag team matchup.
Yeah. Oh, my!
Somersault punched by Edge. And look at Gangrel, Christian, all over. Oh, back in the ring. Jeff
Michael
Hardy
Hayes
on the outside.
Here, look at this!
Matt Hardy elevated. Very similar move that we saw from Edge. It's a train wreck out here.
I mean, Michael Hayes just backdropped Matt Hardy right into the entire Brood.
Well, referee's calling for the bell.